All right, I'm going to admit to something. I knew it was going to do that because this car, when we bought the car, we knew that the brake pedal would not engage. So we knew we had a brake problem. We don't know what that brake problem is, and what we're talking about today is ways to diagnose brake problems, especially on a car that's been sitting up for a while. Now, we know this car will roll because we put it on a trailer. We didn't have any of the brake drums lock up, so that's possibly a good sign. But that pedal not moving is definitely a bad sign. And we'll try to take care of that over the next couple of episodes.
For 45 years, the Miller family and the dedicated staff at Autocrafters have been here helping you to restore your dream Ford. Thank you for your support. Here's to another 45 years of delivering parts for your Falcon, Fairlane, F100, Galaxy, Maverick, and Pinto.
On these master cylinders, especially the fruit bowl master cylinders like this one here, call them fruit bowls, single reservoir master cylinder, however you want to name them, these things can be really bad about this adhering to this. This one is fortunately loose, but I'm going to pull it out of here. Whew. And yeah, it's completely empty, and you can see a little bit of rust residue up here on the top part of the master cylinder. That's not a good sign for it operating. And we already know, I mean, from what I showed you in the intro, we know that that master cylinder is probably shot because the arm's not actuating. But I'm going to do this in a systematic manner. I'm going to go and look at what we have here. Master cylinder's not working. Great. We're going to pull that out of the way in just a second. And then I'll go through and I'm going to check my lines. I'm going to pull the wheels off, check my actual brakes to see what they look like. And as soon as we find out where our problem is at, we're going to go in and start ordering parts and getting everything ready to go. We are replacing this with a dual reservoir master cylinder. I will show you that in a future episode when we go back and start redoing the brakes on the front of this. But this is basically what we would normally do. We do a diag first, and then we go in and we start replacing parts. So we know our master cylinder is dry as a bone and has a lot of residue in the bottom of it. That's the stuff that's in the very bottom of this master cylinder. So we know that we want to go in and definitely, if nothing else, we would go in and replace that with a single reservoir. We talked in another previous episode about how we don't like single reservoir master cylinders, so this is going to be replaced with a dual res. Okay? Okay. All right, diving into the deep dark here. Ugh. Ugh. So, what you're going to want to do is you're going to want to take this out first. This is the tool I prefer for using to take this cotter pin off because it just makes life a lot easier. But you're going to want to try to take your brake light switch off first, or your brake light wiring. These can kind of get stuck sometimes because this can get pretty hot if the brakes are used a lot on these cars. This is your brake light switch. I'm going to try to retain that because it looks like it's a good original one. Go through the hole here and pull that off. Now you'll note that there is a washer on this side of the brake light switch. And then the problem we may run into with this is getting this to move over because of that master cylinder not being in good shape. So we may have a problem getting this all out of here. It looks like I'm going to have to go out and undo the master cylinder from outside. Because this has not got enough motion in it that I can go in and wiggle it around and pull it off of there. Normally, this rod is not tight in there like it is right now, telling me that there's probably rust freezing that into position. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use a little bit of stainless wool to clean some of this paint off. Paint is a deadly enemy when you're doing this kind of stuff. I don't know if I'll be able to get all this paint off, and if not, I may have to do something like what I'm going to do now, which is run a little bit of penetrating oil on the joints. You can also use heat, and I've also seen guys drop a little bit of crayon down inside of these. It'll suck down inside there and lubricate the fitting between the pipe and the nut and make that a little easier to get out. I'm gonna try it with what we've got here, see where we can go on this top one. These Fruit Bowl master cylinders or single reservoir master cylinders are typically, this is like a half inch and a 3/8. And you are gonna wanna use, a set of line wrenches because you could really mess up the actual nut on here if you're not careful. Now the problem I'm seeing right now is what we've got going on is it's actually spinning this part of the tube. It's actually twisting it. And I don't know a good way to get around that because of how these fittings are. So we may end up having to put a line kit on this in order to fix that problem. When people go in and paint things and they get paint on here, it can cause an issue. It won't matter what you do, but that's just gonna twist because it's not wanting to not turn. Let's see if we can get any motion out of the other one. It's acting more like possibly 7/16, but I was hoping to keep these lines and be able to use them to reset them. You can see the paint shattering off of there, but we may have the same problem on this one as well. Yep. It's not wanting to, as I like to say, play nicely with others here. Now, what you can do, if you've got a 66, is you can go in and buy the brake line kit for a 67 on up drum brake system. Yeah, it's just spinning it. It's going to bust those lines up. And as I said, I'm going to try going in and using a little bit of heat on it, but I don't hold a lot of hope that that's actually gonna work real well in this case. See if that does us any good. That took a while. Nobody light a match. All right, let's try this again. Nope, it just broke the line. A lot of times that's what you're gonna run into right there. These lines have been in there so long that you're gonna have a problem with them wanting to break. And it's probably a good idea to go ahead and replace these anyway, especially as dirty as the inside of that master cylinder is. I hate that that happened for Jackson, but we can go in and replicate these lines if we need to in Nycop. I know some of you guys don't like Nycop, but it is a solution that you can use in these instances. Yes, there will be particulate inside that line. And yes, I am going to have to go in now and replace that line with a probably a front kit, if nothing else, on this Fairlane. I mean, Falcon. Great, time to get the tools to take the master cylinder loose. All right, now I've got it loose. I gotta go inside and monk around with all the stuff underneath the dash to separate it. and then we should be able to go in and pull that completely out of there. Hurry, gotta go in for the dive under the dash. Now, I should be able to do that and drop our brake light switch out of the way. And you'll notice there is a, for lack of a better term, a bushing here inside on this. Try to retain these if you can. The old bushings are really nice. There you go. And now I'll go in and pull the master cylinder out, which sounds a lot easier than it feels. Is this master cylinder nasty inside? Yes, I would say that it is. I just pulled the boot off when I sat it down off camera, and that's what I got. My big worry is that I won't even be able to use the push rod because it's nastified inside of there. I'm gonna probably take that into Studio A, our area where we do a lot of our dirty work, bang the crap out of it and see if I can get that to come out, because we would like to be able to reuse the push rod if we can. If we can't reuse the push rod, then we're gonna have to try to find one that'll do the job here. The inside of that bowl is just gross. I'm a little concerned with even what could be going on inside the lines anyway, the existing lines, because of how bad that master cylinder bowl is and all the trash that's down inside the bottom of it. If you don't take care of your brake system, it's not gonna take care of you. Prime example right there. All right, our push rod cleaned up pretty good, thankfully. We wanted to be able to retain that. One thing I did want to point out on this before we head off into doing other things on here is this little thing right here, this little plastic piece that you can see on here. If your push rod does not have this or the metal ring that will sometimes be on here, you probably should get a different one or try to get the little metal ring or the plastic ring that sits here, because that is what holds the push rod inside of the master cylinder. You can accidentally pop the back of the pedal and the push rod can come out and then you have no brakes anyway. Ask me how I know that can happen, because it happened on a car that I was working on one time, and if I hadn't grabbed for the emergency brake and stopped within 285 feet, I would have put somebody's car into a tree. Always make sure that you've got one of those little suckers on the end there, because it's the difference between you stopping and you colliding with something out there in the world. Yep, there's spider webs. Yeah, that's right, spin right to there. Good enough. Okay, I gotta get the nut off of here. We'll see if that drum will come off easily. And you're gonna wanna do this on a system like this one that's sat up for a while. You're gonna wanna do this at all four corners. Don't be surprised if you have to go in and replace every wheel cylinder in this thing. As dry as this one is, we will probably be going in and replacing all of the brakes. We have a friend that just happens to have his drum brakes from his 68, and it's the same setup. Not the worst I've ever seen. No real heat annealing on these. That looks good, but we will check the spindle once we get everything off. The brakes are coming off pretty decently. Should have kept my mouth shut. Yeah. Always check your spindle. I love six-cylinder spindles. This one's fine. If you're gonna do this, you wanna check to make sure that there's no scoring on this portion. This is your ride point for your bearing assembly right here. And you're wanting to run your finger around there and see if you can catch a nail on anything. And right now, he's got a good set of spindles. So here we go. We got the we've got the drum off. I've looked at the drum already. You can look at it, maybe able to see it a little bit here. There is some scoring on the facing of the drum. I don't find that to be too bad. It looks like there's still some surface left on this drum. There's a little beveled edge on this outside that's still on this one. If that beveled edge is gone, then you're out beyond the wear point on the drums and you're not going to get effective braking out of it. But those look like they're in pretty good shape. The scratches and stuff that are on the drum face in here, I see that some because let's face it, you're dealing with the drum brake system. You get some kind of sand or something that's going to get embedded in the pad and it's going to scratch the surface of that drum mating system. Not as big a deal as you might think. Pads look like they're still in good shape. Somebody had gone in and done brakes on this thing before it got put up for good. Everything is in pretty good nick in here. I don't see anything that's wrong. The spring is, or the locker for the expander for the drum brakes, that is outside of its normal position on the bottom half of it. But everything else looks pretty good. Your springs are all correct. These springs are locked in and good. These aren't worn out. A lot of times you'll find those things are just absolutely beat to death. The only thing I would do possibly is to take these off and check the mounting pads for the shoes because sometimes those can take a groove if you're not careful and it'll make the brakes a little bit harder to deploy. We've gone and done a couple of things in the past where we've shown you how to go in and weld those back up and make them okay. I will probably, in the next episode when we go to work on this, we're going to be putting new brakes in here, so we'll tear all this stuff apart, keep everything consistent, and I will then go in and check the pads on the backing plate to make sure they're in good shape. All right, so now the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to look at my wheel cylinders. That's never good. That's not good at all. So it looks like on at least one of these are going to need some wheel cylinders. Because those wheel cylinders have taken on some rust, possibly, or maybe sand. Either way, that kind of particulate being down in there is not a good thing. It's dusty, which tells me it's probably the aluminum wheel cylinder inside of here has chalked up. I'd be willing to bet you wouldn't be able to get that to deploy if you wanted to. So we're going to have to tear that off and get a new wheel cylinder for it. I'm not going to try to rebuild it. I'm just going to replace it with a brand new wheel cylinder. All right, tasty little tech tip for you from the guys here at Manic Mechanic. Basically, it's just me. Did you know that the six-cylinder spindle starting in 1966 is exactly the same spindle as the V8? From then up until 69, when they changed the tie rod assembly on them, went to a larger format tie rod, these spindles did not change between 6 and 8. The only thing that changed was the braking system and the springs and, of course, your tie rod assemblies. That spindle right there will absolutely work with a Mustang or Cougar from 1967 on up, as well as a Fairlane Falcon, Comet, Montego, Torino, and I think that's all the kids in the pool. Same spindle, V8 or 6. Bottom bing, there you go. That's the bottom line on it. So there's your little tech tip from me here at Manic Mechanic. All right, I'm going to take this drum off. Once again, got fairly good material left on the shoes, so I'm pretty happy with that. The drum, same situation as the front. It's got a little bit of grooving in it, but nothing too bad. Although I will say that this drum might be right at the end of the life cycle. I'll have to take the drum and clean it up and see if it's got markings. A lot of times they will have markings around the outside perimeter or on the facing of the drum that will show you what the wear, the max wear on them is. So this one may be at that point that will need to be replaced, but I'm not double sure on that. Harder to get to the wheel cylinders on these, but I will say that these are also the more ignored of the wheel cylinders. Wheel cylinders on the back are usually less well taken care of, but this thing actually looks pretty decent. Springs, everything are in good shape. I probably would go in and replace the wheel cylinder on this, but that usually will mean then we'll have to also go in and replace the brake line because a lot of times you're running the same problems we ran into up on the master cylinder with it wanting to twist the line rather than actually the nut letting go and doing what it's supposed to be doing. All right, so that's really it. All of this looks like it's in good shape. I'm not going to do anything else with this until we can get either the brakes from my friend Bill Johnson, who had a six-cylinder car that he converted over to a V8, so all the six-cylinder drum brake stuff on his car is basically brand new. So we may grab the brakes, shoes, drums, everything that we need from that other car and put those on here and get a new set of wheel cylinders from our friends at Auto Crafters. But we will definitely be buying a line set for the front for the dual reservoir master cylinder and possibly the junction block if it's available. So there you go. Well, that's it, folks. That's our show for this week. The last thing we're going to do on this thing for a minute until we get some parts in here. Do me a favor. Be kind to each other. Love on each other. Treat each other nice. You guys have a great week, and we'll see you on down the road. Trust me, it's going to be a minute. I don't know about for this, but we do have the other floor pan still to do, and a lot of things need to be seen to on old Wonky here. Pretty cool, though.